10-gallon has just been cleaned out. This is where Lydia is currently living. I have to put her dishes back in. She still has food. 2 mealworms left in there from this morning. She's had a bit of a full belly because she shed again last night. No, there is no humid hide in her cage at the moment, but we keep the warm side moist in here when she's shedding, especially. We keep a water dish in there. I've seen her sitting in it. I've seen her licking it, so she loves it. But right now, since I had to clean out the 10-gallon, she's currently hiding in the corner of one of the three 20-gallon long tanks, which this is actually the side of it. It's turned on its side because we have cats, and they love to jump on the screen. They've already managed to tear a whole tiny hole in this one from jumping on it. But I can actually convert this into a front opener if I want. Since leopard geckos don't really need the light, or heat from the light, it just bounces through here. It does warm it up a little bit because of the bulbs I have in there currently. If I wanted to, I could make a miniature castle in here, or probably just a single room from the castle. Hi. Come out here and show everyone how pretty you look after just, like, I don't know, 2 weeks? Let's see, we got her December 20th, and today is what? Today is January 15th. 16th, rather. And look at how much she's grown. She's quite happy. Come on. There you are. No, go back into the light. I know you want a warm spot. I know. See, I don't know what to think of the screen yet. And there's no heat pad for the 20-gallon long. The ones we had were old and would not stick to the side, and I did not want to risk anything happening or them not working. The one we did have that was hooked up to this, we had it plugged in for several hours, and it was still not heating up, so otherwise, you would be in here by now with the few things we have, and I would be working on making something to go in here. Yeah, I know. It's cold there. You're looking for the warm spot. This is not your house. Come on. Come on, I'm gonna put you back in your warm house now. Come on. Come on. It's okay, honey. It's okay. It's me. My hand is warm. There we go. She doesn't freak out when I pick her up anymore. She'll squirm a little bit and fuss until she realizes the hand is warm. And then she'll lay as flat as she can. And she's showing off her nice colors. She's getting more and more orange on her tail and on her legs, and her head is starting to turn orange. She's so cute. All right. Let's go. Look. There's your nice warm cave. You don't want the cave? You're not gonna go right into the cave? Huh? Hey, honey. You have your water dishes there. You have new paper towels. Yeah. You gonna climb your tree? Put the lid back on and put the light back over the top of the cage, where it's supposed to be to keep the cats off. Yes, you're hiding there in the tree. Right in there. Oh, there you are. Well, good. Stay there a second. Now notice my reflection on the glass. Hi. aside from Rydia's little hiding places, we have just so you all know, I'm not walking around. I'm scooching on the edge of my bed because, yeah, I can't walk without these. This. Do I even have to say what's in here? It should be quite obvious. You guys, wake up. No one can see you if you're not moving. You only freeze when I pick the container up, otherwise you're moving everywhere.
It's alive.
Family is actually picking up some more to add to this, so yeah. Many mealworms. So many mealworms. They're all huge, except for like, found you. You're right at the top. That's the smallest one in there. I kid you not. You are the tiniest mealworm I have ever seen. Which is why you haven't been fed to Rydia yet. You get to stay in there. Where'd it go? There it is.
Itty bitty one. Right there.
Let's compare her to one of her neighbors. Or his neighbors. I don't really care, but you know.
Don't run over the little one.